What's up, guys? This is the JP side of things on Dokkan Battle. This is the Boss Rush 10 that was just released previously this week. So without further ado, I'm going to rush through it the first time and see how difficult it actually is. I don't foresee it being very hard, but we shall see. Let's go with it. Alright, I didn't even look to see who is in this, so it's looking like, okay, Hits, Trunks, Kid Goku. And then maybe the LRs? Goku and Vegeta? I legitimately didn't even look into it, so. This is all new to me. How much damage is gonna do? More than I expected, to be honest. That Vegeta's just awesome. There's nothing else to say about that Vegeta. Just awesome. One hit KO again? Maybe. He does. Yeah, didn't even crit. That was good. Good defense though. Also guys, it's been a while since I've done anything Goku related, so it seems like you guys like that the most. So I'm gonna do my best to bring you more of that kind of content. I'm not gonna lie to you, in the past I kinda got a little burnout on it. I love the game, absolutely love it, but when I play it all the time myself, and then I take the extra time to stream it and make videos of it as well, it just got to me as well. But I'm trying. Trying to get back into the swing of things here for you guys. So, real quick, don't forget to hit that like button if you like what you watch. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. And if you have subscribed, or even if you haven't and you do decide to subscribe, don't forget to hit that bell for notifications so you know when I post my latest content. I love this transformation, by the way. This is so cool. The Goku is awesome, too. Here's the Goku. So cool. Also, I'm going to be very upset if I finish this recording because I haven't stopped it yet or checked it or tested it or anything if I don't have any game audio. I know I have volume for music and me, but I forgot to check. My bad. Also, I don't think I'm going to get a... Yeah, I am. Just kidding. Okay. Rolling. Not getting a super do that. That's fine. That'd be good. Another thing as well, I'm gonna be doing summons on the new Vegeta and Vegeta banners. I'm focusing on Vegeta first. Vegeta is my favorite character from the two. Even not being biased, I'm just looking at the banners. I really do think the Vegeta banner is better overall. So I'm going to be summoning primarily on that Vegeta banner. First off, if I can pull Vegeta and whatnot, then I'll go over to the Gogeta one. The top priority for me is Vegeta, followed by that new Trunks unit, because you guys know how much I like Trunks. will finish it off here. And in. Now we just get LR form. Is really good in my opinion. I like this team quite a bit. This is all Super Saiyan 2, and then the Majin Buu is a Resurrection Warriors, and seeing as the Vegeta has that secondary category, or first Vegeta is. Either way, he has both category leads, so it works out great. And that Buu actually does help. Pretty good support unit for the Resurrection Warriors. I do want to get a super with him. He does. It's either greatly lowers attack or greatly lowers defense. I think it's attack. I haven't looked at it in a while. I haven't played it in a while, so that's why I don't completely remember. And had I been paying attention to how much damage I had done, I would have known that I would never have gotten the super tag off anyways with the Buu. Alright, first one's over with, no problems whatsoever. On to Vegeta. Alright, this agility. I'm keeping the Vegeta and the Goku together here. Together in the same location, if I'm lucky, and they transform, they'll both be transforming at the same time, so that's what I want. One shot this second phase. I would really like for that team or that group of three to one shot the next phase, and then the third phase be back with Vegeta and the Goku, and they will transform. That's my hopes at least. Will it happen that way? Probably not. Well, this is a friend, and he is like 80%, I think. The defense system, so. Also, I haven't used any of the new items and stuff you put on the characters in the potential system, equipment, whatever you want to call it. It's still kind of confusing me. I don't know. It's just different. Very different. Awesome. One turn. Taken care of. Transforming right here. Love to see it. That is just amazing transformation. Also, real quick, I totally forgot to do that until just now, so let's put that on Do Not Disturb so I don't get any random notifications while I'm playing. Alright, just got better defense. Looks like the Vegeta just barely. Either way, it's going to be very good, clearly. Alright. Alright, Dokkan attack. Alright, this is a one turn. Watch me miss these. It's been so long since I've done a Dokkan mode. Yep, failed the two. It's fine, not salty anymore. Damage you want to take on a super hero. that's like my main is my global, and how do they expect me to save for year 5 when we got the new strength cooler coming, we got this new Vegeta and Goku coming. Here in a minute we're gonna have the future Gohan, the INT one, which I'm not too pumped about him, to be honest with you, but I am pumped about the secondary unit that comes released with that banner, which is the new Trunks. So I am excited for that card. Not getting a super with the Goku. May have been a bad move there. I'm not gonna use my tech ones. Let's do that. It'll be fine. Maybe you'll get an additional if I'm lucky. Vegeta's done. Three more to go. We got Kid Goku next. As usual, keeping Vegeta together. They don't necessarily need to put together all the time or at all, but I like to the transformation requirements are so specific on both of them that if I just keep them both together, one transforms, so is the other one. So it makes it easier for me to get them transformed. And then once they're transformed, it doesn't matter where they're at really to me, as long as you know they're getting some sort of boost from some sort of link skill from somebody. Unfortunately, well, that strength margin for Vegeta is I don't have any dupes in him. This JP account is fairly new still. This is my main JP, but I started JP around the time of Goku, the new LR Goku, so it's not very old. And this right here is the reason why I have them together, because if one transforms, now they don't necessarily have to stay together, but... Also, guys, what are your opinions on the new LRs? The new Vegito and the new Gogeta. Which one do you guys like better? I really would like to have a discussion with you guys about that. Not being biased towards the 51 in general, just what do you think is better, that kind of stuff. So, let me know down in the comments below what you guys think about those units. What do you guys think about the new Trunks and the new Bardock as well? Those are pretty sweet looking cards, too. Also, like lastly, I guess, what are your thoughts on the banners? Because these banners are like the best banners I think I've ever seen. I think the Vegito banner is better overall based off of what has EZAs now and just the other cards in general. But like all of the cards that are considered fodder normally at the end of the banners that are featured, all of those units on the Vegito banner are all EZA units now, or are going to be EZA units very soon, and they just look amazing. So, it's really hard to say that the Vegeta banner isn't good. Very hard, actually. Alright.
That'll be fine.
It'll be fine.
I don't expect this to do too much. Plus it crits. Hopefully it crits. I still did a pretty good amount of damage. This type is in range, but okay. That'll definitely take care of it. Goku and Vegeta, Super Saiyan 2 ones that transform, they're like still some of my favorite cards in the game. Like, even with the new Vegeta and Gogeta, I think the Vegeta is amazing looking. The Gogeta has crazy animations, but I still like the Vegeta better. I'm just a Vegeta fan. Always have been. Always will be. All of that, but it's okay. Yeah, it's fine. See? It worked out. Alright. We've got the AGL one next. Fitting for two AG or two tech Vegetas here. Take good care of that. Honestly, it won't get past Goku. Considering I can't get super with the last run anyways. Oh well. Vegeta's just too good. That works for me. That'll be fun.
It'll be fun.
I really wish we could get some dupes of that mind with Vegeta. Eventually. Alright. Should we have together? You're as good as dead.
Awesome.
Screw that one up. Take care of business. 4.3 mil. And the other Vegeta's transforming now. Just in time to take out the last stage of it. All right. There we go. It's not going to take him out, but good bit of damage. Shiva? Nice. This might do a little bit. Not too bad. Is it just me, or are these bosses just too easy? They just feel too easy. Final stage, which is Trunks, I believe. My probably still to this day favorite unit in the game. The Tech Trunks. Also, guys, don't forget, as soon as the Dark Souls series is done, which is pretty soon, I am going to be starting Kakarot. So if you guys are interested, if you guys are interested in that, just let me know. It should be fun. I've not even watched anything on it, really. I've seen clips here and there of it, but I have not paid close enough attention to it on purpose. So it's still new and fresh to me when I see it, when I start playing it myself. So, I'm hoping it's good. I've heard some negative things, a lot of things that cut out of it. That kind of sucks, but overall, I'm hoping the experience is going to be fun. I don't think transform is no matter what order, although. Obviously, I love Dauntless. I wouldn't mind going through a fresh run through of that game. Trying to just think off the top of my head other games that I do want to play. The other Dark Souls games, the other two in the original remastered. Demon Souls is another one that people seem to be interested in. I've never played it. It was only on PlayStation 3. I didn't have a PlayStation 3, so I've personally never played it, and I would kind of like to see what the fuss is all about on that one. It started the Souls game, so. Bloodborne as well. That's another one. Not busted. I do have Borderlands 3. Could maybe do something with Destiny 2, of course. Yeah. there's a lot of games that I want to play and share like, my experience with you guys. Like, I love this game, but I don't want to be just tied down to just this one thing. Like, I want other things to play and fun with, you know? That being said, too, honestly, Legends just seems to be going more and more downhill, in my opinion. And Dokkan's just going up and up, so you're probably not going to do much, if any, of Legends anymore. Maybe here and there I'll do it for fun, but it's just not the same game. You know, it's not like what it was. Man, this is... Oh, Rafi. There we go. I made something out of nothing. Like that. Okay, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, almost 6 bars down on the first turn. We can take care of it, maybe. There should be a few. So that is Boss Rush 10. That's all there is to it, really. Wasn't hard. We're gonna get 35 stones, and that'll put me over 200. And I will be making a video very, very soon. And we'll be doing some Vegeta summons, guys. That being said, if you guys like this video, hit that like button, hit that sub button if you haven't already done so, and hit that bell for notifications so you can stay up to date with all of my latest content. Guys, thank you so much, and peace out. I will see you all in the next one.